Whenever you begin learning something new, there are always going to be terminologies and concepts that are specific to what you're learning. It's often like learning a language of a country before you visit. Once you understand and can speak that language, you're going to have a far better experience when you arrive. WordPress itself has a number of terminologies that are specific to its ecosystem, and grasping these before you dive in too deep will be of great benefit. Hi, I'm Ryan, and welcome once again to the Learning Hub. In this lesson, we're going to fly through a list of 16 terms and concepts that you will most likely come across as you begin building your website with WordPress. We've touched on a few of these in past lessons, but some of them will be new concepts. So you ready? Let's jump in. The first one is one you'll become very familiar with, and is actually the first thing you'll see when you log into your WordPress website, and that is the WordPress Dashboard, or also known as the WordPress admin. Your WordPress dashboard is where you find access to everything you need to manage your website, including quick links found in the toolbar, all manner of options in the sidebar, and the main dashboard, which shows a number of widgets that can be customized. More on this in later lessons. The second concept is one we've mentioned before, and that is the WordPress Core, or Core. Whenever you hear this, it's simply referring to the default setup and functionality of how WordPress comes out of the box. Creating pages, posts, users, and managing media are all examples of core functionalities. But as we've mentioned previously, the beauty of WordPress comes when you begin to customize. And these next few terminologies are how we do exactly that. So number three is themes. We've looked at this one in the past, but basically this is the look and feel of your website. The theme you choose will dictate a lot of how your website appears, but also it'll often provide additional functionalities. Next are templates. This is one that can easily get confused with themes. Templates are the actual structure of your website's pages and sections within your theme. Many themes will offer a number of templates to choose from, giving you different layouts for different purposes. Next up, plugins. If you've been following along with these lessons, you'll already be familiar with this one, and you've probably already had a chance to install a few. Plugins basically add specialized functionality to your website. And here's a quick tip. When searching for plugins, pay close attention to the number of active installations, the star rating, the last time it was updated, and the compatibility. This gives you an idea of how trusted the plugin is by the WordPress community and how active the developer is in keeping it updated. Number six is your database. This is basically a table where all of the information or data of your website lives. Normally speaking, your database is hosted and managed by your website hosting service. For number seven, it makes sense we mention hosting. Website hosting is basically the location where all your website files are stored. This includes all the source files that make WordPress work, as well as the images and other files that you might upload to your website. Hosting services range in feature and price depending on what you need, but normally you'll be faced with some kind of management panel with a range of options to configure things like domain, files, SSL certificates, and more. Number eight is pages and posts. This is one we explained in our very first lesson, but is really important to understand the difference. Pages house static content, just like your website's main pages, home, about, services, contact. Posts, on the other hand, are used for blogs and news articles. Posts generally will have a published date and are displayed on your blog with the most recently posted at the top. Next up at number nine, revisions. Revisions are basically a history of the changes you've made to your content. Each time your content is saved, a revision is created, allowing you to roll back at any point. This is very, very handy. The next one is another we've mentioned before, but number 10 is permalinks. These are a way to control how your URLs are displayed to attain a clear and easy to read structure. Number 11 is the block editor. The block editor is the default tool used to add content to your pages and posts. It provides a wide range of blocks you can use to add content to your pages and posts and help create the desired layout. Number 12 is the classic editor. Before the block editor was on the scene, WordPress had a basic word processing tool you would use to add and edit your page content. The classic editor is still available to be installed as a plugin, but it's being phased out as its replacement, the block editor, gains traction. Number 13 is one you'll hear a lot, and that is page builders and website builders. Plugins such as Elementor allow you an alternative way to build your website and create your content. Page builders and website builders not only provide a visual experience as you edit your content, but bring additional features to control the global elements of your website. Next up is widgets. Often themes will provide specific locations for you to add widgets to your website, sometimes in the footer or in the sidebar. These could be simple bits of text, a form, a menu, a page builder widget, or your latest blog post. The second last one is taxonomies. Again, this is one we went over in the first lesson. Taxonomies are a smart way for you to organize your content by adding categories and tags. Without getting too complicated, categories usually link your content by broad subjects, whereas tags are often more micro-level topics that are relevant to your content. Finally, number 16, front-end and back-end. These are terms that started off as developer speak, but are regularly referred to when using WordPress. Basically, the front-end is what your visitors see, your website. The back-end, on the other hand, is everything else, your WordPress dashboard, and even your hosting console. So that completes our lesson on WordPress terminologies. I hope you've learned something new and are feeling more and more confident with your WordPress journey. As always, if you haven't yet, make sure you join Elementor's vibrant community and check out the Academy and blog. Catch you in lesson 6.